for. Welcome. Whew. And my cat is at the door. Of course. I'll be back.
Come in, friend. Thank you.
Okay, the whole crew is here. Happy 2024. Cool. As you can see by the title of this video, I wanted to talk about my knitting ins and outs for 2024. I kind of wish that I could do an everything I knit in 2023, but I honestly don't have the energy to figure out everything that I made in 2023 and then also to find it and then also to talk through it. And I don't really have the time at the moment. And yeah, I feel like, oh, sorry if the camera just jiggled a bit. That was the cat. So what I've decided to do instead is do a list of ins and outs in my knitting life. I've been seeing people do this for just like their life in general, and I've done one for my life in general, but I found that a few things for knitting were on it. So I wanted to make one that was like just knitting and then just talk about it in like a really short little video. This video is going to be mostly just me talking. I don't plan on showing any knitted objects because I've not had the time to kind of gather them up to talk about them. I'll be referencing different projects, but this would be a good episode to stick on while you're washing up or on a walk. It's basically, this is mostly audio, so take that, you know, get out an interesting project that you need to look at and settle in for a little audio journey with me. So I'm just gonna cut to it because I've got places to be. I've got stuff to do. One of my ins, go start with the ins and then do the outs. Is that a bit, that's just the order they are in my notebook. One of the things that I want to be in 2024 in my knitting life is monthly podcast episodes. Am I gonna regret saying that? I don't know, but that's my goal, is that I'd like to post at least once a month, just updating everything that I've been doing, because I like having this as a record of what I've done. It means that potentially at the end of the year, I'll be able to actually do an everything I've knit in 2024 video. Yeah, so one of the things that's gonna make that possible is letting go a little bit of the perfectionism in me and just recording and not having it need to be perfect or not needing it to be super long or whatever. I also, I'm running out of space on this memory card, which is also why I don't have that much time. So maybe that's a good thing for me. So monthly podcast episodes, in. Next thing that is in, sweater quantities of yarn. This is something that I feel like was informally in 2023 for me, where I kind of gave myself permission to just like buy a sweater quantity of yarn if I had a project that I really wanted to make. For example, this bonnie cardigan, which I made, I think quite early on in the year, actually. I did find in my phone notes that I had started working on, like, keeping track of everything I made in 2023, and I think I made it to maybe, like, February or March. I also think after that point, I kind of stopped finishing objects, so maybe that was a full list, or, like, a close to a full list, but anyway. Yes, sweater quantities of yarn are in. I feel like, I've been reading this book about stashes. It's called A Stash of One's Own. It's like essays. It's edited by Clara Parks. I'll stick it down below. I read it on Scribd, which is the app that I use for reading different books. And yeah, a lot of people were talking about like giving yourself permission to like buy the yarns that you want to buy. And I think what I want to do is make jumpers and buy like lots of one type of yarn. Little projects just don't always give me the joy. I want something big, but it's a lot of money, and I feel like I just panic because it's also like a lot of yarn to hold on to if I don't use it. But I want to use it, I will use it. So sweater quantities of yarn are in. Next thing that's in, gauge swatches. Controversial. I feel, I don't want this to be a pressure thing. However, in my year of like making more garments in 2023, I feel like I have not got the fit that I wanted to on all of them. E.g. this, I love this pattern. I love the color yarn that I want. So this is the Bonnie cardigan by, I'm pretty sure I know, but I don't want to attribute it to the wrong person. So I'm going to stick it down below, in the Kremke Soul Wool Reborn yarn, which I'm a big fan of, but I made it, I think, in the wrong size. And I also didn't really do a gauge swatch. It's a bit bigger than I would have liked, especially kind of around the neck. So gauge swatches. The next thing on my in list is knit to fit, which is one and the same. I want to really focus on fit this year and making sure that I get things to fit the way that I want. Another jumper that I made too big this year was my port sweater, which is very sad for me because it's such a beautiful jumper and I think I would wear it all the time if it wasn't too big. It's just too big and I tried to felt it down and I'm gonna try to felt it down again, but it's just a real shame. So gauge swatches and knit to fit are in. It may not always be a success, but that's something that I really want to focus on this year, is trying to get things to fit the way I want, whether that's fitted or oversized or whatever, but to have some more control over it than I currently do. That's the goal. Next thing on the in list is, it's just the DRK everyday sock. It's in. I like it. It's a good pattern. I've discovered a sock that I actually enjoy to wear directly on my foot. I'd knitted a lot of socks before that I liked visually, was pretty happy with, but I had to wear them over like tights. I'd have something that was like actually tight to my foot and then put it on, or wear them as like bed socks. But the DRK everyday socks actually fit my foot and I can wear them without anything else. So knitted socks are in, specifically tight fitted knitted socks and the DRK everyday sock. Excellent. Next thing that's in, comfort projects. Comfort projects, they're just in. I don't know if there's anything more to say. I want to enjoy the knits that I do this year and I want to feel comforted and cozy. I think comfort for me in this case means easy to memorize patterns, things that I can knit that have just enough interest but don't require me to be like completely focused to do them. So yeah, I think a lot of jumpers come under that category for me, because there's usually like jumpers or cardigans or garments or like this sort of thing where you've got a little bit that's complicated and then it's like knit in pattern for 5 inches or whatever. So that is my comfort project. I'm also considering another half and half wrap thing because I use it a lot as like a blanket or like a little shawl, and it was just really fun and cozy to knit, and just having something on the needles that is like a long ongoing project where it's just the knit stitch would be great. So comfort projects are in. Take a little tea breather. A little actual breather. Good. The next and final thing on the in list is donating yarn. Again, this is something that's been informally in 2023. I've donated a lot of yarn, but I think specifically what is in about this is not feeling guilty about donating yarn and not feeling like guilty about having bought it in the first place and therefore holding on to it, being like, oh, I bought this and I didn't use it and I never finished that project and what a waste. No, none of that. If I'm not using it, fine. If I don't want to use it, also fine. I made a mistake. Well, not even a mistake. I bought something. I didn't want it. It can go. That's all right. There are other people who will use it. Sometimes it's hard to let go of things, but I want to make space for all those sweater quantities. And I only have one, well, I have two, technically. I only have two airtight containers where I can keep my yarn. And that's the space I have. So donating yarn is in. And that completes my in list. There are probably lots of other things, but I came up with this list this morning. So this is what is in it that I came up with. Outs. Checking the time that I have. Okay. A little bit of time. Good. I also have to leave for work soon. It's all fine. Out list. A lot of my out list items are kind of just complicated ways of saying things that are in, things that I want to do, but I had to put some stuff on the out list, so you'll get it once I start going. Out list, number one, very related to the last on the in list, holding on to unloved whips. Again, no shame. I cast on a project, I don't want to finish it. Unravel it, pass it on. Or unravel it, reuse the yarn. Unravel it, hold on to the yarn for a few months and see if I want to do something with it. No shame in having whips that I don't love. And also just being honest with myself, because I think often I actually am thinking of like quite a few specific whips and being like, am I going to take my own advice on this? I think there are some things that are so close to being finished that I'll probably finish them and then donate the item, which is actually also on this list, is holding on. What is out is holding on to knits that I don't wear / use. I think I can really hold on to things because I've made them, but I actually only have so much space. And if I want to be making new things, which I do because I love knitting and I also want to get to a place where I have knitted objects and a wardrobe that I wear stuff all the time that I really like, it's going to involve getting rid of stuff that I don't wear and I don't want to hold on to. Now, there might be stuff that I don't wear that I do want to hold on to, and that is fine. However, there's a lot of stuff that I don't wear and I don't really want to hold on to, but I'm keeping just because I made it. None of that in 2024. If I don't want it, I can donate it, I can give it to a good home. It's okay. Also letting go of the idea that I need to find like the perfect home for things, because I obviously know their value. I'm like, I spent a month making this. I bought this yarn here, and then I bought this other yarn here, and it was hand-dyed by this person, and blah, 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 even though I don't like the colours, and I don't like the fit, and it's sweaty for me, and don't wear it. Someone else will enjoy it, and it's okay, and I don't need to, like, try and get it to the perfect place. I have a few jumpers that are sitting in my car right now that I think I'm just going to donate to a charity shop, even though I'm like, what if they end up like in landfill? What if that happens? I really hope it doesn't happen. Like, I hope someone buys it, or someone like who works there takes it and like appreciates it for what it is. But I think I'm letting go of the responsibility of that. I don't know how that sits with my eco consciousness, but that's what we're trying for this year, is just being okay with that. I don't need to hold on to these things just because I don't know what's going to happen to them if I don't. Great. Next thing is very similar. Holding on to unloved yarns. That's kind of the same as donating yarns being in. I think I was running out of things to write down at this point. Next thing. Oh my goodness. Okay, I have to switch over to another memory card. Hold. Okay, we're back. And I have 2 minutes to wrap this up. I hope you're all enjoying this little hello, here's some stuff that I'm thinking about video. Great. Okay. Also out. Itchy yarns. If I can't have it next to my skin, I don't want it. Bye-bye. Gone. Some things get softer when you wash them, so fine. Also under this category is yarns that are unpleasant to knit with. If I'm not enjoying the knitting experience, it's out. If it's like tight or like, I don't know, is this just like cotton yarns and like really like starchy? You know what I mean? Yarns that where I'm like, to get them around the needle, out, gone, goodbye. No time for them. I'm not gonna, unless I like really, really, really want the object. All of these have caveats. I'm allowed to change my mind, but I'm not a worse person if I give up on knitting with projects that I'm not enjoying and that are difficult to knit with. Doesn't need to be difficult. Can just be fun. Last thing, and this is one that I feel like I will go back on, and potentially have already considered going back on in this video, is casting on shawls that I won't wear. Originally, this was just casting on more shawls. I was like, shawls, we're done. However, I then remembered about the MCAL, and then also I'm like, what if I want to make like the Sophie shawl, which is kind of a scarf, but kind of a shawl. Where's the line, you know? So, excuse me, I was teaching all yesterday, I have a very sore throat. Where is the line of what's a shawl and what's a scarf? So I changed it to casting on shawls that I won't wear, which is hard to predict, but I know. I think I can be honest with myself about what I will and won't wear. I don't really wear a lot of shawls out of the house because of like the types of coats that I have, especially this time of year. In the autumn, spring, maybe like a little bit more, but I don't want it to be like a hard and fast rule where I literally can't make any, even if like I want to make another half and half wrap, right? That's kind of a blanket. It's kind of a blanket. It's not. And like the mystery knit along, that doesn't count because it's not a shawl, it's an event. It's a challenge. So, again, up for consideration, up for debate. But yeah, that's my last thing that is out for 2024. And that was also the thing that I thought of first. That was like what kicked it all off, was I was like, shawls done, especially because in the process of like thinking about, okay, what am I going to keep that I've made? What am I not going to keep? A lot of the things that are in the to-go pile are shawls because they're comfort knits. I love making them. Don't wear them. And there's only so many blankets you can keep on your body at one time and keep in rotation. So that's that situation. Yeah, that's my little list. Please consider this a tag video if you are a video maker, and even if you're not, become one. Be a video maker. Talk to me video form. What are your ins? What are your outs for knitting in 2024? They can be as general, as weird, as specific as you want. Take the concept and run with it. It's yours. I'm giving it to you. Yeah. I'm going to go to work and I will see you for the January monthly podcast episode. It's happening. It's happening. Or maybe even before then. Who's to say? But I'll see you soon. And have a good January.